Hi Church, how life can change in a short space of time. In light of the President's announcement on Sunday evenings and the restrictions that we have placed on gatherings, the elders met last night and we decided upon the following things. Firstly, Sunday Church. While we may not meet in large groups at the moment anymore, we do still want to have the option of meeting together as God intends. So for the next 4 weeks, Christchurch Cascades will meet in smaller home group churches. So these will generally consist of the growth groups or hospitality groups that we have already. Each group will meet for a 4 p.m. start on Sunday afternoons at designated homes. So your growth group leaders have indicated the availability of their homes and they'll be in touch with you in the next few days. How's this going to work? Well, Richard and I will provide each of the groups with a service kit, and each group will receive the same service outline with its readings, prayer points, songs that you can sing if you want to sing together. We will pre-record the sermons and we will post it on Christchurch Cascades YouTube channel. We'll make the sermons for this 4 weeks shorter. We'll try to be a bit more kid-friendly, so that if any of the older kids want to be part of the service and listen to the sermon, they can. But we will also provide children's material for the kids if you choose to have them do their own thing. What we're going to try and ensure is that each group has at least 2 kids' church teachers so that they can take turns to facilitate the kids' program. Remember, this is temporary for the next 4 weeks at least. And while things may not run as smoothly every week or as smoothly everywhere as you'd like it to, while it may be slightly oddly different, I think this is still a chance for us to do and enjoy something that's quite unique. It's going to be a chance for different people in your groups to use their gifts, and it's also going to be a wonderful chance for us to grow closer to one another. Now, some of you will choose to avoid any gatherings, even such smaller ones. Don't worry, we haven't forgotten about you. The service structure that the group leaders will receive, we'll also place on our church website on Sundays, so that you, if you're the head of your home, you can lead your family in worship at the same time as what the groups meet. Because even if we do have to do it virtually, we can still remain obedient to the Lord when He says, "Do not give up meeting together." And so these smaller groups, smaller meetings will start from this Sunday, the 22nd of March. Now, just other practicalities, you can choose in your group whether or not you want to share supper after the service, but I just want to encourage you to meet responsibly. So wash your hands, don't share food off the same plates. All those relevant medical precautions still count and we still need to do them. And if you or anyone in your family is feeling unwell, or you've been in contact with someone suspected of having the coronavirus, please stay at home. Regular growth group meetings. Seeing as we are entering the holidays, growth groups would generally not have been meeting over the next 4 weeks. But if you do choose to meet to encourage one another and just to see people, please again do so responsibly. And this goes for mom's group as well. My suggestion is you forgo shared snacks, you keep your hands washed, etc. The minute that you or your kids are feeling unwell, even if it's just a little headache, don't go anywhere. Easter weekend. We are still in consultation with a campsite and we'll let you know our final decision on the Easter weekend in due course. If you find yourself self-isolating or you need to stay at home because you're under quarantine, and you require any help, your first port of call is your growth group. Even though we might still be staying at home, we're still family, we want to be there for one another. So if you need anything, let your growth group know, and if the problem is bigger, we can sort it out within the church. Finances. Towards the end of last year, we introduced the Deacons Fund, a fund for those in our church family who are in financial need and who require some assistance. Please be aware that if you are battling financially at the moment, and if that's made worse because of having to stay at home and not being able to work, you can use the Deacons Fund. Get in touch with either Craig Briscoe, Diane Markham, or Samantha Mayer. They are the Deacons Fund committee. And if you need their contact details, you can get in touch with me. What the elders have also decided is that we will put a halt to all non-essential expenses so that we can keep church finances aside for any needs within our family or even those needs outside of the Christchurch Cascades family that we might feel compelled to meet. On that, we want to think about serving the community at this time. It's been one of the main attributes of the Christian church over the last 2,000 years that when there have been times of plague, these have been times that Christians are able to show the hope they have in Christ and the love they have for their neighbors. So we want to, as a church, be ready to help our neighbors and communities. Individually, that means we can be aware of the needs around us in our neighborhood, especially the elderly or the infirm. Perhaps you can love your neighbor by doing their shopping or just phoning them and chatting to them and seeing they're okay. As we see how or if the virus progresses in South Africa, we can also see how best we as a church community can help within the larger community, whether it be in our hospitals or our police stations or elsewhere. If you become aware of a need that may require church involvement, please get in touch with your elders. Just on the issue of domestic workers or employees, look, we can't dictate to you how you run your personal life, but I do want to remind you as Christians to act out of love for others. Many of our employees rely on the income they receive from us to feed their entire families and provide for a large group of people. So if you do decide to give holiday to your staff, think carefully about whether or not or how you can continue to pay them. Remember as well that townships and rural areas are full of people who are more at risk of contracting coronavirus. And so we need to be careful about exposing our employees to the virus unnecessarily. Mission. Even though our mission evening this Thursday has been postponed and our outreach Easter services are changed now, we can still use this uncertain time to share the hope that we have in Christ. Peter reminds us in 1 Peter 3, always be prepared to give a reason for the hope you have. In light of this, we are hoping to provide you with some existing resources that are floating around the internet, as well as producing our own. Lastly, remember the Lord. These are times that we need to hold on to the truths that we know and have been taught. God is still in control. God is still good. To calm your heart, read your Bible more than you read News 24. Cast your burdens onto Jesus. He cares for you. Do not be anxious about anything. Just take a moment and think to yourself, that takes on a whole new meaning, doesn't it? Do not be anxious about anything, but bring all your requests to the Lord. These are interesting, challenging, and different times. We remain God's church even when we can't meet together as the full Christchurch family. We can still express love and fellowship and concern for one another, and I hope that God uses us at this point in time for each other's good, for the good of our city and the good of our country. Don't hesitate to phone either myself or Richard or any of your elders should you need any help in these next few weeks. Thank you, guys.